What are the primary challenges facing the adoption of electric vehicles today? And what is the role of digital twins in addressing the complexities of EV design and performance optimization? I'm Asma from Ansys, and you're watching the Twin Talks. To answer these questions, we are joined today by Dr. Raja Badrinarayanan, a digital twin expert at Ansys. With a PhD in flow battery simulation, Raja possesses a deep understanding of how battery solutions can benefit from system simulations. With more than a decade of research and product experience, Raja helps Ansys customers in realizing their ambitions of digital transformation. Thank you for being our guest for this EV-focused episode.
Thank you for inviting me, Asma.
Raja, what are the main challenges facing the adoption of electric vehicles today?
Okay, yeah. The first and foremost is the cost. So the price parity between an EV and an internal combustion engine vehicle, typically an ICE vehicle, is significantly reduced in the past decade, but it's still much more expensive to buy an EV when compared to a non-EV in the same segment. Secondly, when we think about it, it's the overall topic of charging. So we will start with, okay, the time it takes to charge an EV is not the same in the same scale as the time it takes to typically fuel a petrol or a diesel car. Having a home charging setup is great, and in many cases, better than even going to a fuel station. But it's not feasible to enable this for mass market where you have like most vehicles typically parked in shared spaces, like on the streets or in apartments. So it's difficult to like have charging infrastructure at that scale. And then we also have this topic of range anxiety, which is another hurdle for, and it serves as a byproduct of this fear of not having the possibility to charge a vehicle reliably. And thirdly, the main challenge is also the maturity of the technology. So in a sense, it's counterintuitive because given the pace at which companies are evolving to satisfy this EV demand, it is only natural that the technology gets better at a much faster rate than traditional technologies. And say the core components, when you talk about batteries, motor, power electronics, etc., they get significantly better with every iteration of the vehicle. So you buy the same car 2 years ago and like you buy something, an updated model, it's significantly better than what you would have seen in that kind of an iteration. So in some sense, people are actually waiting for the next big breakthrough. Like, okay, can I get a great upgrade in myself? Maybe like it happens the next year or it happens the next 6 months. So they're just waiting for the next big breakthrough.
Raja, could you elaborate on the role of digital twin technology in addressing the complexities of electric vehicle design and performance optimization?
Sure. I'm not going to go into the whole details of Ansys digital twin definition or the vision, since again, like there are other twin talks that's done in the past and like experts talking about those specific areas. So talking specifically about the role of digital twins in EV design and optimization, I would like to go back to some of the critical elements of building these twins. EV development is a complex engineering problem involving several departments to collaborate on a single goal. And the possibility to quickly perform multiple design iterations through technologies such as, say, reduced order modeling, helps in arriving at a desired optimal design much sooner than traditional methods. And digital twins also help democratize simulation, which are traditionally done only by engineers with very specific or niche expertise and access to large compute resource. So today, with these technologies, decision makers are enabled to access more nuanced information in a user-friendly way with significantly lighter models. So you can imagine a case where, like in the past, if someone has to sign some sort of a warranty document, it would involve like a lot of text files and like Excel files, so on and so forth. But now with these kind of technology, they are enabled to at least like run the aging model or degradation model to see if they can actually satisfy the warranty claims that someone is signing off on. So it's really helpful to bring this to decision makers. And the possibility to perform virtual testing with simulation is also critical, considering the cost sensitivity and the time to market pressure faced by the OEMs today simulations are greatly improving in terms of how they're used in performing virtual testing.
And how can digital twins contribute to overcoming challenges such as range anxiety and battery degradation?
So range anxiety arises from a few factors. The main ones are like, one, not having the possibility to drive long enough in just a single charge. Two, not being able to charge reliably and fast when you get to a charging station. And three, a lesser talked about factor, that is where like the range estimation in the car is not accurate enough for the user to trust the displayed range. So being able to run, say, a system level model with good modeling accuracy and fidelity greatly helps the manufacturer to optimize the efficiency of the powertrain, thereby increasing the range for the same battery capacity. So this tackles the first problem of being able to run longer with the same capacity of the battery. So you do not want to over-engineer something to make sure that it goes longer. The second point of charging performance, it's also influenced by several factors, such as temperature of the battery, state of charge, state of the health of the battery, and having a reliable twin to test several cases, run water analysis, and doing all these things to find the right strategy for charging greatly improves the user experience. Then talking about reliable models, they also help in achieving good accuracy when it comes to range estimation. It is good to note that there are several different flavors of digital twin depending on the kind of information or data you have. For instance, with Ansys's hybrid digital twin approach, the model parameters can be calibrated online so that longer term deviations are accounted for. So this you can imagine, like, so if you have a range estimator that's accurate enough that can tell you the right range, whether it's winter or summer, whether you're at 10% battery or not, then it will improve like whether you can trust the system well enough to reduce your range anxiety. There are also several ways of approaching, say, the topic of battery degradation, but I would like to provide a simple example on how digital twins can help OEMs and customers. One of the key areas addressed by digital twins is predictive maintenance. So let's consider a case where, say, a car from a German manufacturer is being used in Australia. In a case where there are no digital aids, a customer has a degraded or a faulty battery, they realize that, oh, they are like stuck in the middle of a highway. They have to call someone, go to a service station, and then in the service station, it stands for like months for the new battery to be shipped, to be replaced and gets back to the customer. So now let's consider another case where an OEM takes advantage of this predictive maintenance enabled by digital twins. They can preemptively identify these kind of degradation mechanisms depending on the usage. Then they can ship the battery to the nearest service station and call for a replacement even before the customer realizes the issue with a degraded battery. So it's a win-win for all the parties involved. So you have optimized logistics for the OEMs. They can save on money on how they are going to manage the shipment. And the customers are not going to be without a car for like months or weeks together. So that's how it could help customers when we talk about battery degradation.
Ansys is known for its simulation solutions. How specifically does Ansys support electric vehicle manufacturers in tackling key technical barriers, such as battery management, thermal management, and overall vehicle efficiency?
On the structural side, we have tools like LS-Dyna, where they support the evolutionary change in battery design, where battery is being used as a structural component. And also it helps with cases like crash, where like the users may want to see how does like a degraded battery, if it is swollen, if it has vented, how does that perform when there is a battery crash? And then we also have like control tools when we talk about battery management systems. SCADA is used in many cases for code generation so that you have reliable control on how the battery is managed during operations to make sure that you have efficient and reliable predictions of estimation, one of the topics that I was talking about earlier. And then on the system level, we have Twin Builder, where like you have all things coming together. You can connect Twin Builder to flagship tools Then you have a guided wizard specifically to build cell and modules from test data. Then we have the whole concept of reduced order modeling. Again, this is served by several tools within Ansys, but you can also bring in, say, third-party tools or Ansys flagship tools directly as a reduced order model and work with them in TwinBuild. Then we are also kind of an open ecosystem. So there are like tools from other third-party vendors can actually brought in through an FMU. And we also have this whole portfolio of like using hybrid analytics and deployment support to do prediction, predictive maintenance. So as you can see, like this is a whole list of different things. And we have not even covered the complete portfolio on what all can be done. So depending on different needs, we have several tools. And they all kind of also work together because this is a collaborative effort to build this whole EV platform. So all these tools need to interact together to make sure that you have a solution that is competitive.
Raja, how do you envision Ansys continuing to play a pivotal role in addressing emerging challenges and optimizing EV performance?
Sure. Considering how critical simulation is to EV adoption, Ansys makes sure that there are enough solutions or the right solutions exactly when the customers need them. So we also work with customers when implementing the solutions to improve our products. We hear feedback. We make sure that we are always competitive when we are on the solutions that we offer. And our solutions also like focus a little bit to be on the open and the collaborative side. So we also, like I mentioned, FMU is one aspect of it. A lot of our tools support it. And we also have a plethora of tools that are that can be accessed to Python, through Python. So we have this whole PyAnsys portfolio where So for Twins, we have PyTwin, or you have like PyADT, where like several of our tools can be accessed through Python. So if you have an internal workflow where you want to connect tools that are using that you're using internally, there are possibilities to bring them into Ansys portfolio to make use of the best products for those specific needs through different parts of our solution. And we are also continuously working to develop new solutions, new tools to make sure that we are collaboratively advancing this EV adoption together.
Thank you so much, Raja, for being part of this Twin Talk episode.
Thank you. Thanks, Austin.
For those who are interested in this topic, Ansys Digital Twin experts are presenting a dedicated webinar to show you how to streamline electric vehicles from design to operations with hybrid digital twins. The webinar will also focus on methodologies and best practices for developing models, calibration through AIML, and their integration into IoT platforms. Stay tuned for this upcoming webinar and for the next episode of the Twin Talks. Thank you.